Hey guys, it's Kristen and Bethany here with Girl Defined Ministries, and today's vlog is called Making Your Single Years Count. I think the single years are one of the most unique seasons of life because you really, like, it just hits you one day and you realize, I'm single, and that can kind of happen at different ages for different people.
Well, and Bex, our younger sister, Rebecca, she's 18, and I think she's starting to feel that way, like, oh no, like, am I officially becoming a single? Yeah. It's weird.
It is weird. So it's kind of a season where one day it hits you and you're like, I'm single. And then you're on this journey of singleness, but it's kind of, it has a mysterious end to it, right? And for some, it may never end. You just don't know. So you're on this road of singleness, like, I could be single forever. I could get married next year. Like, I have no idea what this journey is going to look like. And so I think that can create a lot of confusion. Just worry. Inner turmoil, worry, anxiety about the future. We can tend to be very fearful in this season, or we can tend to just like pour our lives into something because we're like, I don't know what to do. I'm just going to do this. And we're not even sure what we're doing. We just busy. So I think in this post, we really want to talk about singleness. And you've been single for, I don't know, 29 years.
I'm not married. I'm not engaged.
She's in a relationship. Y'all know that. But so she was single for 29 years. I was single for 24 years before getting married.
Barely anything.
Hey, no, it felt like a long time then. But there were things that we did during our singleness, intentional things that we did to not just waste those years, to not just drudge through those years, but to really make those years count. And so in this vlog, we really want to share some encouragement with you on what we did and hope that we can encourage you to make your single years count as well.
Like Kristen said, I am 29 and not married. And as a lot of you know, I am in a very intentional, very serious relationship, but I didn't even get in that relationship until after I'd already turned 29, and I'm going on 30. And so that's a lot of time to be single.
A lot longer than you were imagining when you were young.
Than I was imagining, and just really unexpected. And I'm sure a lot of you find yourself in that position. Some of you probably even older than me. Some of you maybe like Kristen was 24, but it's still these feelings of what do I do? So there are two specific things that really made a difference and an impact in my singleness and honestly helped me to not just endure the single years, but to really thrive in them. And so I really want to share these with you in hopes that you can grasp onto these, apply them to your life, and really make your single years count. So the first thing that I did is I chose not to view my single years as an in-between stage. It's really tempting to view these years as like a holding station. Like, I'll just kind of try to get through these until I get married. And so we busy ourselves with really nothing at all because we're just waiting, hoping for the one day our Prince Charming will come into our lives and we can finally really start living. And that is a, I believe, terrible mindset because God has us here right now for a reason, for a purpose, and we need to use these years that he's given us for his glory. And so when I really shifted my mindset and said, no, I'm not going to use this as a holding station. I'm going to live all out for Christ right now. It really changed the way I lived. So that's the first thing I want to challenge you. Don't view these years as an in-between stage. And the second thing I want to encourage you in is to be busy doing good things. This really helped me in my years of singleness because it wasn't just like, okay, great, I have no purpose or reason to be alive. I was like, no, there are so many things that I can do, good things that I can do, not just like, you know, random stuff that makes no impact on anyone's life. And you're like, why am I even living? You know,
Busy for the sake of busy isn't the idea.
It's not satisfying at all. Being busy serving Christ in specific ways, specific to your location, talents, gifts, all of that. A few things that I did was I loved basketball. And after I graduated from high school, I decided to go and coach a younger basketball team. So like 8th grade, 9th grade, and one of my sisters played
so
on
cute.
It. And it was so fun because I had this group of girls that I was going to be with for several months. And instead of just coaching them, I decided to try to invest into their lives.
Disciple them.
We would have a Bible study after every practice, and it was just a really cool way to use my single years being busy doing good things. And there were a lot of other things that I did during that time, but that's just an example for you. Look at your life, say, what do I enjoy? What talents do I have? And get busy doing good things during your single years.
I think for me, I acknowledged my singleness for the first time when I was probably like 16. So I was a little bit younger, because I thought, you know, I really want to get married by the time I'm like 19, 20. That would be ideal. I had that kind of dream per se. And then I didn't get married till I was 24. So yeah, for some people that might seem like, oh, you got married young. But at the time, it felt like a really long season of singleness for me. And so during my singleness, I wanted to be intentional too. And looking back, I really wish I had been more intentional. I feel like even since then, we've learned a lot about how to be even more intentional. But there were some things I did that really helped. So we were involved in a local church, and I decided to get really involved in my local church. And if you're involved in a local church, I really encourage you to not just brush past that. Like, oh, it's just church. Like, I'm going to go pour in over here or do this other thing. Like, no, God gave us the local church for a reason. That's his good structure for us as believers to have fellowship, community, to serve, to have accountability, to hear solid messages. Yes. I mean, to hear truth. Like, church is so important. And so for me, I got involved in my local church. There was all sorts of opportunities. I worked in the youth program. I went on mission trips. I got involved in the Awana program. Ended up directing that right before I got married. And some other things I can't think of. Maybe VBS during the summer.
You did a lot with church. I remember
that. There's so much, that you can do if you're intentional and if you don't just go to church on Sunday and leave. But say, how can I really invest? I'm single.
That's a great point.
I have more time. I have more flexibility. How can I pour into my local church and serve? And that for me made a huge difference during my single years. And I just want to challenge you to get involved in your local church as well. And the second thing I want to encourage you in is to pursue a genuine relationship with God. And I say genuine because if you're anything like me when I was single, I had a relationship with God and it was genuine. But I think for me, a lot of times I was just going through the motions or like doing what I knew was right and like praying and reading my Bible. But maybe my heart wasn't as in it as much as looking back now, I wish it had been. And now that I'm on the older end, looking back, seeing, wow, making that time for the Lord, investing in a relationship with him is so important. It's foundational. Because that's really what you build your life on, is that relationship with God. Mm. It needs to be strong. So if I could go back, I would have been even more intentional with building a personal, intimate, daily relationship with God. So what does that mean? What am I talking about? I'm talking about not just opening the word and like reading it, checking off the box, praying, but actually saying, Lord, would you change my heart? Would you teach me your truth? Would you show me how to love you in deeper, more intimate ways? And a passage that I'm constantly coming back to is Psalm 16, which says, I have set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my whole being rejoices.
That's good.
And during a season of singleness, when you have a lot of instability, uncertainty, maybe worry, temptations fear, for fear, worry, you don't know what the future holds, all of these things, just that verse, I have set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be shaken. And that comes, that kind of confidence that the psalmist has in the Lord comes from a daily, abiding, intentional relationship with God. And so as you're single, I just want to challenge and encourage you, don't overlook that. Don't think when I'm older, I'll pursue a relationship. Once I'm married, I'll get serious about it. You know, then I'll really make my relationship with God a priority. No, do it now. Make that such a priority, because that will last for your entire life.
Our prayer really is that you will just take a moment today, if you're single, and to just stop and kind of ask yourself, okay, how am I doing in those specific areas? And maybe just evaluate. Maybe you need to get more involved with your local church. Maybe you're relationship with God is not that great right now. Maybe you need to really focus on that. Or maybe you've just had a really bad perspective on your single years. Whatever it is, we really want to just challenge you to maybe pick one of those areas and focus on it for the next coming weeks. You don't have to do all of it, but just take one step, because we really don't want to see these years for you to go by and then for you to look back and feel like, man, I really wasted this time, or I wish like, I would have done something. Yeah, with so many regrets. We're sharing this with you now so you can start today. No matter where you've been in the past, you can start today fresh, moving forward in a good direction. That's just really our prayer and hope for you in making this vlog. Thanks so much for watching today's video. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. And if you want to see more from us, you can subscribe to our channel below, because we post new videos every Wednesday.
Ministries and to...
something fun.
Woo! Okay, loosen up.
Yeah, loose.
Yes, thank you. Okay, see? Woo!
It was perfect.
Oh, let me start over.
Oh, that was perfect.
Like, I know.
I was already like this.
Okay.
Like what? I literally thought they were somewhere salting over each other. You're going so fast.
That are really blah, blah, blah. Okay.
So let's have interaction and let's try not to say so, because I was about to say so. Okay. And then I'm like, oh.
If these vlogs have helped you in any way, and the time that we've poured into this channel has been an encouragement, a blessing to you, has like maybe changed your life in some way, which I know some of you have contacted us and said, your YouTube channel has changed my life. We love that. That is awesome. Now, y'all know that we're on Patreon. That's how this YouTube channel is supported. And if you've been hearing about Patreon and our channel is encouraging to you and you're like, I've kind of been on the fence, I don't know, like, should I support them, should I not? Then we're just asking you right now to take that leap of faith, come on the other side of the fence, and give just a dollar per video. It's awesome because you can give a really small amount, but when a lot of people give a small amount, it makes a really big difference. So would you come join us on Patreon, partner with us in this YouTube channel so we can keep doing what we're doing. We can continue encouraging you by giving a dollar per video. And to see our channel or our Patreon page, just click the link below.